Dear all, welcome back. We are discussing about the operations on a set. So we already discussed this complement of a set, union of a set, intersection, disjoint, difference of sets. We already discussed about this. Now we are going to discuss about symmetric difference of a set. So we are going to discuss about symmetric difference. Okay. So we start with the definition of symmetric difference and then we'll see the example on it. But if you want to watch my previous videos for complement union, you can find the link above top right. So we'll start with the symmetric difference now. So see here, we have a symmetric difference of two sets that we have to see. This is the definition of symmetric difference. But before that, we have to assume something. Here we are assuming X as the universal set, and set A and B are the subsets of given universal set X. This is what we are assuming, and now we'll see the definition of symmetric difference. So symmetric difference of two sets is nothing but the set of elements either in A or either in set B but not in both. Means what? If you are taking the symmetric difference of two sets, set A and B, then we have to consider the elements from both sets, set from set either from set A or from set B, but we have to skip the elements which are common in both. This is whatever the set, resultant set you will get, that is nothing but the symmetric difference of set A and B, that set we can call. Getting my point? So here how we can denote this. So here we have some symbols. This is what one symbol to represent the symmetric difference, or we can write like this, or we can write like this also. So these are the symbols used for symmetric difference. Okay, so we'll see the property form of symmetric difference. So a symmetric difference B is nothing but X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B, but X does not belongs to both A and B, means intersection of two, that we have to omit, means we have to avoid that. Getting my point? So this is the definition of symmetric difference. Now we'll see one example on it, so our point get clear. Okay, see, this is the example. Here we have A set, this is set A, and we have set B. So A set having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and B set having 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we have to find the symmetric difference of these two sets, and here we have a universal set X. So these are all the elements from universal set X, and this is what we have, Venn diagram, right? So now we see the result of A and B, means we have to find the symmetric difference of A and B. So we have to consider the elements from A as well as from elements from B set. But which elements we have to skip? The elements which are common. These are the common elements from A and B. These two elements we have to skip, and we have to write the remaining elements in A intersection B. So here we have to consider that. So I need to edit this part, right? This is wrong, right? This is not the correct result. So you add with me. So which elements I have to consider? So see here, we already considered 1, 2, 3. We have to skip 4 and 5 because which are common. And we have to start with 6, 7. Then here we'll write 8. Then we'll write 9. Then we'll write 10. Getting my point? So now the result we are getting, that is the correct result we are getting, right? So you see here, A 1 2 3 1 2 3, we are elements from B 6 7 8 9 10, and which element we have to skip? 4 and 5, because these are the common elements. Now whatever the result we are getting, that is what the symmetric difference of A and B. So this is the correct result what we are getting, right? Now we'll see the Venn diagram. We have to shade the portion which shows represent this symmetric difference. Getting my point? So this is the Venn diagram. Here we have a universal set X, and here we have set A and B. We already represented these elements in this universal set, as well as belongs, whatever the elements belongs to A and B, we are written. This is the common portion of A and B. Okay, so So now we'll find the symmetric difference. We have to shade this portion, right? So how we'll shade the portion? This is the result, right? So 1, 2, 3, this portion, and 6, 7, 8, 9, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, this portion. So symmetric difference we have to show in the Venn diagram. So we have to shade the portion which gives us the symmetric difference, this part, right? So we'll use the shading portion. So we'll shade this portion. This part will be there, this part. So I'll shade this portion except common, right? Other part will be there. Okay, so this is what our symmetric difference. So shaded portion represents the symmetric difference of A and B. So now you see here what exactly mean by symmetric difference. So if you are finding A minus B, then we are getting one formula here. A symmetric difference B, this symbol I will use. A symmetric difference B is nothing but A minus B union B minus A. Can I write like this? Yes. When you find B minus A and A minus B and you are taking the union of these two, will get the symmetric difference A and B. So this formula we are getting. In this way also we can find the symmetric difference of A and B. So this is all about symmetric difference of two sets. You can find such a symmetric difference of more than two sets also. Getting? This is a symmetric difference. We already covered this concept. We are done with this. So we'll see the next points in my coming videos. Thanks for watching this video.